become 4. So, to subtract 2 from the 4, move 2 beads down. Then, there are 2 beads attached to the answering bar. So, the answer is 2. So, now the answer is 2. In this way, we have to do the calculations with the abacus frame. Now, let us see another problem. Find it in abacus. So, this is the problem. We have to add 2, 1 and 5. Here 2 plus 1 is 3 and 3 plus 5 is 8. So here the answer is 8. And now we have to find out this answer in abacus frame. So this is the abacus frame. And now these are the beads. And now with these beads we have to find out the answer. So first one is 2. Then, to get 2, in the 1's place, move 2 beads up. Then the answer is 2. So again we have to add 1 here. So move 1 bead up to the answering bar. So the answer is 3 here. And now, to add 5, in the 7 beads. In the 7 beads, that means upper beads, this is the 5. That means here we have to move down the 5, move down the bead to the answering bar to get 5. That means in this way we have to move the bead. So it will become, there are 5 plus and 3 beads here. There are totally 4 beads touched to the answering bar, and 1 is 5 and 3 are in 1's place. So 5 plus 3 we get 8. So now the answer is 8. In this way we have to find out the solution in the abacus frame. So now again we are going to see another problem. Find it in abacus. Here the problem is 1, 9 and 3. We have to add these 3, and by adding these 3 we get 13. So now we have to find out this answer in the abacus frame. This is the abacus frame. And now these are the beads. Now first take 1. So in the 1's place, move 1 bead up to the answering bar. So this one, 1 bead is moved up. And now again 9. We have to add 9 to this one. So to add 9, we have to subtract 1 and then later we have to add 10 for this. So first we have to subtract 1. To subtract 1, move 1 bead down in the 1's place. That means 1 is moved down. Then in the 10's place, move 1 bead up. Then it will become 10. So the answer is 10 now. And now again we have to add 3 to get 13. So in the 1's place, move 3 beads up, and then it will become 13, because in the 1's place there are 3 beads up to the answering bar, and in the 10's place 1 bead up to the answering bar. So 10 plus 3 we get 13. So the answer is 13. In this way we have to find out the answers with the abacus. Now again let us see the another problem. Find it in abacus. 3, 4, 5, minus 6 and minus 3. So for this option, for this answer is 3. Here 3 plus 4 is 7 and 7 plus 5 is 12 and 12 is in the positive position. And these are 6 and 3 in the negative position. 6 plus 3 we get 9. Then 12 minus 9 we get 3. So we have to find out this in abacus. This is the abacus frame. And now take the beads. Now take 3 first. Now in the ones place, move 3 beads up in the earth beads. So 3 beads moved up. Then again 4 here. To get 4, add 5 and subtract 1 from the 5. Then it will become 4. So to add 5 above the my house point, move the bead down. So then it will become 5. Now to get 4, subtract 1 from the 5. So to subtract, move 1 bead down. Then it will become 4. That means the answer is 5 plus 2, that is 7. And then now we have to add 4. One bead up above the my house point, that means 5. Move one bead up to subtract 5. So the remaining is 3 here. There are 3 beads touched to the answering bar. So now the answer is 3. In this way, we have to do the calculations with the abacus frame.